renal variation. Cause is tedious, which is non-productive type. Shortness of breath, insidious in onset, gradually progressive, did not show any diurnal or postural variation. Yellowish discoloration of sclera since 10 days. Discharge from both the ears, yellowish purulent and foul smelling. Abdominal distension and melena since 8 days. Bleeding, diarrhea, rash, fetal edema, facial puffiness, herbal medication intake or contact with TB. The child has recurrent infections in the past for which she was given symptomatic treatment. The child is third born to third degree consanguineous marriage. She had two elder siblings who also had hypopigmented hair and recurrent infections. One of them died at 5 months and other at 9 months of age. Birth history, full-term normal vaginal delivery was carried institutionally. Child was breastfed immediately after birth and continued exclusively till 6 months of age. Immunized till date. Developmental history, social smile at 2 months, neck coating at 3 months and babbles at 7 months of age. The primitive reflexes have disappeared. Anthropometry reveals that child falls under the third percentile. On general examination, child was found to be irritable. There is hypopigmented silvery hair and eyebrows seen. Pallor, ictus and cyanosis were seen. No clubbing, lymphadenopathy and edema. Skin was appearing normal. There was no ocular albinism present. Temperature was 101 degrees Fahrenheit. Examination of respiratory system revealed that there are bilateral diffuse crepitations. Examination of reticuloendothelial system showed that there was hypopigmented silvery hair, no enlarged lymph nodes, abdomen was found to be distended. On palpation, liver was palpated 5 cm under the right costal margin, rounded border was seen, and soft in consistency, there was no tenderness elicited. Splenomegaly, span was 9.5 cm, it was firm in consistency, notch was red, and it was not tender. There was no tenderness elicited in the bones. On percussion, liver span was found to be 12 cm. Examination of CVS, H1 and S2 were heard and there were no murmurs. CNS examination showed that there was decreased tone, deep tendon reflexes and extensive plantar reflex was found. This is the case summary. Provisional diagnosis could be hemolytic anemia with bronchopneumonia, but because the child has hypopigmented hair and recurrent infections, these could be the possible differential diagnosis. So to confirm the diagnosis, further investigations were carried out which showed pancytopenia, elevated serum bilirubin levels, PT, INR and APT were elevated, serum ferritin and triglycerides were increased. Hair microscopy showed that there are clumps of melanin granules distributed near the medulla, which is suggestive of GRISCELLI syndrome. So these are the features which are showing that it could be GRISCELLI syndrome with secondary hemophagocytosis. Then counseling was done to the parents about the seriousness of the illness. And child was started on ceftriaxone and augmentin. Because the symptoms did not subside, she was given vancomycin. Vitamin K was given and transfusion of platelet-rich plasma was done because the platelets were low. Levipil was given to control seizures. She was intubated in view of poor saturation. These are the silvery hair syndromes which should come into our mind whenever we come across a child with hypopigmented hair from birth. We can confirm the diagnosis by hair microscopy which reveals these. In GRISCELLI syndrome, we can see small and large clumps distributed near the medulla. In Celiac-Hikachi syndrome, uniform sized melanin granules are distributed evenly. In LHRD syndrome, it is also similarly as GRISCELLI syndrome. Thank you. Depressive disorder, because there is
so this is also already on education and different SAM or the type of management to be able to try. So what do you think the mothers to do for the further planning of the babies?
Now if the mother plans for next pregnancy, before that we should counsel her that there is every chance that the next child also can have the similar disease. So, if she wants to have the pregnancy, we can advise her for prenatal amniocentesis where we can detect the genetic mutation if it is present.
Third child has also suffered already 2 days. So, this is the third child. So, do you think it is a mutation or it is only the AR?
I mean, there is a mutation in the gene which is carried, which is inherited.
How many types of GRISCELLI are there?
There are 3 types of GRISCELLI syndrome. This child is having second GRISCELLI syndrome type 2, where immunodeficiency is predominantly seen.
Can you have a class in secondary HLH.
Yes. In HLH, this is hemophagocytic lymphohistiocytosis. What happens here is there is defective regulation of NK cells. So because there is decreased NK cell stimulation, there will be increased T cells that will release interferon gamma and tumor necrosis factor. They will result in they will stimulate the macrophages. Macrophages will phagocyte other blood cells and they are infiltrated in all the organs. So we can see pancytopenia as the main feature. Anemia, platelets are also decreased, so there will be increased bleeding tendency, which in our patient manifested as melena, and we thought it could be intracranial bleeding that was leading to seizures. And there will be increased ferritin levels, triglycerides are increased, organomegaly will be seen, hepatosplenomegaly.